गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ बायोलॉजी ऑफ क्लास 9। एंड वी वर लुकिंग फॉर लेसन टिश्यू एंड वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ प्लांट टिश्यू ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन। एंड वी वर लुकिंग फॉर एनिमल टिश्यूज, वन काइंड ऑफ एनिमल टिश्यू वी हैव सीन, दैट इज एपिथेलियल टिश्यू, एंड टाइप्स ऑफ द एपिथेलियल टिश्यू ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन। नाउ वी विल गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट एनिमल टिश्यू important role in our body, and the name of that tissue is muscle tissue or muscular tissue. Okay students, so we will talk everything about some common properties or some common characteristics of muscle tissues, and its types also we will see in detail. Okay, so why do we require first of all muscles or muscular tissue in our body? See, our whole body is made with a skeleton.
Due to the presence of muscular tissue in the body. So this is the first function, this is the second function.
muscle fiber, right? These are called as a muscle cells or muscle fiber, right? Fiber is just like the thread, long thread, understood? So this is made up of, or muscle tissues are composed of muscle fiber. So this is our first property, composed of muscle fiber. Okay, muscle fiber means what? The thread like structure it is. Okay, muscle fiber. The second property of this muscle tissue is muscle tissues are elongated and large. Okay, elongated and large. These are the common properties of all muscular tissue. Now, the third property, which is quite important, that this muscle fiber or muscle cell contains a specific kind of proteins in it, and those proteins are responsible for the movement and for the locomotion. So, such proteins are said to be contractile proteins. Okay, in your book, contractile protein is given, but the name of the contractile protein is not given. So, in exam, if you will write the names of those proteins, then well and good. But if you are unable to write, no problem. So I will let you know the names of those contractile proteins which are responsible for the contraction and relaxation of the muscle which causes movement of the body, right? So contractile proteins are present into the muscle tissue. Proteins, which are those? Myosin and actin. These are two contractile proteins present into the muscle tissue, and these proteins are responsible for what? Contraction and relaxation. Okay, these are responsible for what? Contraction and relaxation. Now, what is meant by contraction and relaxation? See, students, see at the hand here in front of the hand, these are biceps and back of it are triceps. So whenever I am taking my arm towards my shoulder, that is contraction of muscle. Okay, and whenever I am keeping it far from my shoulder, that is called as a relaxation of the muscle. Do you understand? So this kind of movement, contraction and relaxation, is because of this contractile protein, that is myosin and actin, and this process is called as a contraction and relaxation. And continuous contraction and relaxation leads to movement of the body. Understood? This results in the movement of the body. Okay? So these are some common properties or common characteristics of the muscle tissue. What are those? I would like to repeat them again. See, these are composed of muscle fiber. Okay, means thread-like structure is present. Okay, the second property is elongated. These muscle fibers are elongated and large. Third property is it contains contractile protein known as myosin and actin. And this myosin and actin is responsible for the contraction and relaxation of the muscle, and which causes the movement into the body. Okay. These are some common properties of the muscular tissue. Okay, and there are mainly three kinds of muscular tissue. What are those? First muscular tissue is skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscle. Second is smooth muscle. Thank you. muscles are attached to the skeleton. This is the properties. These are the properties of a skeletal muscle. Okay, so attached to the skeleton. Okay, skeleton. Skeleton means we have a skull in our body. We have a backbone in our body. We have rib cage, right? So various kinds of means our organs are there, and which contains skeleton in that. And skeletal system is composed of 206 bones. Okay, in small child, in a baby, it contains 306 bones. We have seen in the lower class of this all the things earlier. We have gone through it. So student, you are quite acquainted. You have acquisition of the skeletal system, right? So skeletal system, whenever it is attached to the muscles, that is called as a skeletal muscles. Okay, so the first characteristic is attached to the skeleton. Okay.
Fatigue is occurring for those muscles very earlier than other muscles. So, Spindle shape means what? At the
shell. Spindle shell means what? Pointed ends are present, or tapering ends also you can say. Tapering ends. Tapering ends means like the shape is like this. So this is spindle shape. At the middle, it is little bulky, and at the end, it is pointed. This is called as a tapering end. Okay. So the first point is these are elongated, but spindle shape pointed ends or tapering ends are present. What is the second? It has a nucleus which is centrally located. Okay. It is uninucleated, means only one nucleus is present. involuntary muscles. Okay, means their movement is not on R-wish like skeletal system. In skeletal system, the movement is on R-wish, but here the movement of this muscle is not present. It is not on R-wish or it is not working on our brain. Okay, so these are said to be involuntary muscles. Okay, so three names are there. Visceral muscles. I shall let you know why the name is given. Then aspirated, aspiration itself, and involuntary, which is not in our hand. Working on our wish. Okay. So now, what is the function of it? If such kind of structure is designed for this muscle, then what is the function? Students, you might be knowing peristaltic movement. If you are not knowing, I shall let you know. So, peristalsis or peristaltic movement, these muscles are responsible. Okay, now I shall let you know through one example. See, when we engulf the food with the help of our tongue, when we engulf the food, it is moving into the oesophagus. How many from you students are thinking that oesophagus is just like a pipe?
Here also, the food will move in the peristaltic movement.
Students, this is ovary and ovary releases every month one egg and that egg is transferred from here. It has to transfer. And in my epithelial tissue lesson, I have told you here some cilia structure present, okay, which makes the path very easier. Eggs can pass very comfortably towards the uterus. This part is called as a uterus. This is called as a uterus. So whenever the egg comes here, after whenever the egg comes here, then egg goes out through vagina every month. That is called as a menstruation or menstrual cycle. So the movement that egg also coming out through vagina in the form of the peristaltic movement only. So the wall of the uterus are also made up of this nude muscle. Understood, student? Means this. Can heart exhausted? Can the heart muscles get exhausted? If heart get exhausted, then we will be dying, right? So these muscles are continuously working. Heart can never say, now I am tired, I shall take rest for 2-3 days and I will not do. What would happen to our body? Right? So the function of heart we will see in higher classes. So heart is made up of this cardiac muscle, and cardiac muscles are never taking rest, and these are not working on our mission, will continuously these are working. So these are also never getting exhausted. Okay? So, do you get students some common characteristics of it? These are cardiac muscles, the name of it. These are elongated, cylindrical in shape. It has a nucleus, right? The nucleus is present, only one nucleus is present. These are branched, like previous one, two types. These are not unbranched, this is branched. And at the junction of the branching, this is disc is present, and that disc is called as a intercalated disc. The function of the intercalated disc you will learn in many classes, and these muscles are never getting exhausted. These are never exhausted. Continuously these muscles are working. Okay? So, what are the things, other things through which it can recognize? As these muscles are only present into the heart. So, this is said to be cardiac muscles. Okay? And
due to that only we are alive. Okay, I am talking in front of you because of my heart is working.
by the